So in this video, we will take a closer look at the Coupler.io UI, where certain things are located, and how to get started with the tool. So without further ado, let's get into it. As soon as we log in, we will land in the home page of the app. This is your screen that will help you get started with your first data flow. It will have pop-ups and notifications about newly released features, important videos, and also dashboard templates that are relevant to the use cases you've been playing around with in the tool itself. Let's go top to bottom and kind of see what the menu offers. First of all, we have the collect section. This is the core part of the app where you are able to configure your data flows completely from scratch. The concept of a data flow is quite important to the tool. This is where you'll be able to grab the data from applications you work with, transform them, send them to a destination, and put it on a schedule. Data flows is also something that all of our templates use to provide you with visualizations. Before we move forward, let's take a quick look on how to set one up and go through this part of the app. So to add a new one, we'll click on Create. You'll have two options to choose from right away. So pre-built datasets are templates that offer essentially pre-configured sets of information with different use cases, different types of blendings, aggregations, and so on. Feel free to filter by sources, by categories, and just find if there is anything you want to save configuring anything by yourself. If you don't find it, no worries. We do have an option to start from scratch, and let's use the start from scratch as an example here. The first step would always be to plug in a data source or sources. For the sake of this video, I'm just gonna pick LinkedIn Ads, the one that I have here. I've already connected my source account, but when you do this for the first time, you will have to authorize the app and just log into it to allow Coupler to do its thing. And then once you've done it, following with the steps of the application, all you'll have to do is just click through adding the account, specifying different report types or entities you want to extract. Each source is a little bit different, so just be mindful of this. And then specify the report period, metrics dimensions, you know, check on the advanced settings, and so on. We'll have dedicated videos on all of the features and functionalities that we will go over in this video in greater detail. So I'll skip it and then we will link them below. So once you've connected your data source, we'll go to transformations. And transformations is a place where you can not only preview the data that you're working with, you can also rearrange your columns, change their names and types. You can apply filters, sorting. You can add new columns with the help of our formula-based feature to this existing data set. And then you can also create different transformations and different types of data sets. You have options to blend your data if you're working with more than one data source, append and join, and then you also have an option to aggregate your information. Let's take a quick look at what these allow you to do. So append is very simple. It's going to stack your tables one underneath another based on column names. Think Google Ads and Facebook Ads, same metrics, same dimensions, just different sources of data. Join is kind of like a VLOOKUP type functionality. So to look at different tables you're trying to match and based on a column or columns as your key, in case there is a match, it'll put everything in one line for you. And then aggregation is a quick way to apply certain functions like sum, count, count unique, min or max, based on dimensions and metrics that you want. So we'll have dedicated videos, like I mentioned, for all of this. So just know where it is, know what you can do, and let's move forward. Once you're happy with the view here, the third step is to pick a destination where you want to send your data. We support quite a few different options, including AI destinations, which we'll discuss a bit later. So let's say for the sake of this video, I want to plug it into a Google Sheet, and just following with the flow of the application, I'll specify my spreadsheet, pick a sheet, define cell address and range, which in this case I will skip. When you work with Google Sheets, you also have a couple of import modes, replaces the one I want to go with, and then I'll click on save and run. The final step would be to put something like this on a schedule. Let's say I want to do every single day at 9 hours, my time zone. As soon as this executes, the final result is going to be in the Google Sheets, exactly the same as we saw in transformations. So let's take a closer look. And then over here, this is the information that we have, or we had in transformations, now transferred over to the spreadsheet. Let's move forward now. If you create a new, or once you create a new data flow, it will be listed here. You have some controls to copy it over, to edit it, to delete it, and so on. And the next section would be sources. As you saw, there is an option to connect the sources you want during the process of setting up a data flow, but you are also welcome to connect them here. And then once connected, you'll have an option to make them private or shared. Destinations, same as sources, but they, you know, that they work with your destinations. So you can also make them private or shared if it makes sense. And you can also connect them here as opposed to connecting them within the data flow, whatever works best for you. Now let's move on to the visualization part. So in here you'll see templates in my dashboards. Templates are essentially a gallery of all of the pre-canned reports that we have for a wide range of destinations. We won't go through the setup process, we have another video for it, but just know that you can filter by different categories, different sources, and destinations, and pick the right template for your use case. Once you create templates, they will be stored in my dashboard sections, so you can easily find them and access them. Moving along to the AI powered section, we have a couple of options here. So AI features such as AI insights for dashboards. Please note that this specific feature is only available within the Coupler.io dashboard templates. So let's select them here. So if the template destination is Coupler.io, let's look at the PPC multi-channel dashboard, one of the most popular ones we have. If we click on the preview over here, you'll note that there is an AI insights button available. So you can apply certain filters. Let's say maybe I want to extend my date range a little bit, and then I want to generate some AI insights. Very useful and cool feature where you'll get trends and summaries, key findings, and also top recommendations based on your data. Moving along to the MCP server, or as you saw in the data flows, AI destinations. So it is possible to connect Coupler to AI tools as your destination. At the moment, we work with Claude Web and Desktop and ChatGPT. As you can see here, we'll be adding more tools as well. And the whole idea is that instead of sending this data over to something like a spreadsheet or Looker Studio, you can connect it directly to an AI tool and start conversing with the AI tool about your data in natural language. Very useful, very powerful, and we do have a whole other video outlining the setup process, recommendations on how to get started, tips on how to get best insights, and so on. To wrap this video up, let's take a quick look at the settings section. This is essentially your account management type portal. So you have the users section here where you can invite other people into the tool and give them proper role accesses. You also have your billing section where you can decide which plan you want to subscribe to. We prorate all the charges so you can switch from any plan to any plan at any moment and decide if you want to pay monthly or annually. We also have add-on offerings. You're welcome to explore what additional benefits you can get by leveraging our BI team on top of the software as a subscription service. And then just account over here where you can change the name of it and also let other people join your organization starting from a certain tier. That's it for the overview this time around. Hope this was helpful. And should you have any questions, don't hesitate to get in touch with our support. You'll always find this contact support button and can start a conversation whenever you need help.